Hey all, it's Jess. So my book is selling copies and I'm really happy. So thank you so much if you bought one, if you contributed to it, if you've just been following me and supporting me. So thank you. It makes me super, super, super happy. Anyways, so I got a question from a follower about hyposensitivity. And I did a video on this already, but I kind of wanted to do a series on it depending on your senses. I think it's important to know about because to understand autism, then obviously by my name, you have to look at it holistically. And so hypersensitivity is more recognized as an autistic trait, and more hypersensitive autistics, especially children, will get diagnosed instead of hyposensitive autistic children because it's much more evident to their parents that there is something different about their child because they are tactile, hypersensitive, or they get really stressed out with lots of input and noise and lights and stuff. And so I want to go into detail and give examples about hyposensitivity in autism. So part one is going to be about auditory hyposensitivity. So first off, sensory processing. That's how our nervous system receives, interprets, and then responds to sensory signals. And so when you're hyposensitive or sensory underresponsive is another way that they say it, the sensory input has a lower effect on us. And so we need more input to receive the sensory signals, and then we also have difficulty interpreting or responding to those signals. So auditory hyposensitivity is basically you can't distinguish words or sounds, or you perceive them incorrectly. I'll have a delayed response to noises. Especially if I'm concentrating on something, then noises don't mess with my concentration. And so I remember once I was in elementary school and I was just reading my book after a quiz, and I was reading, and I hear someone call my name, and I look up, and the quiz was over. The kids have all given it to their teachers. Everyone was in line at the door, and everyone was staring at me, still sitting over in my desk reading, because I was just so into it. And so, not hearing stuff until it gets louder or repeated. It presents as auditory processing disorder. For me, I will hear someone when someone's talking, then I mishear what they say, or confuse words that they are saying with another word. So they can say boat, and instead I thought they said float. Stuff like that, words that rhyme or words that sound like each other. A lot of time it feels like people are mumbling all the time, and I have to listen very carefully to distinguish their words as a sentence, not just a jumble of I always need subtitles on movies because all the words just get mumbled together. Also music. I listen to music very loudly, and sometimes it takes me a minute to actually recognize, okay, what song is this when I turn on the radio, because it just kind of all seems kind of fuzzy until then, when I concentrate, then it clears. Another way of mishearing sounds, I'll hear something and it sounds like ringing, and then if I get closer to the sound or I just keep listening to it, then I realize it's not ringing, it's beeping, and it just like it just confused me what it sounds like. What else? Some noises that affect other people don't have any effect on me. Like an ambulance driving by and everyone turns to look at it. I just didn't realize anything was happening until I saw everyone looking that direction, and I was like, oh, what's happening? So stuff like that. And I'm in a crowded room or a crowded building, then I can't hear everything that's going on. It's all this jumbled sound, and it's kind of muted. It's kind of when you go underwater and you can't really hear any distinguishing sounds. It's kind of like that. Some quick disclaimers. Auditory processing disorder does not mean that you are auditorily hyposensitive. You can have auditory processing disorder and be hypersensitive. It just coexists in the same for me. Also, your sensitivity to things might change depending on if you're in a really stressful circumstance. When I was working in the coffee shop and I was trying to struggle to get everyone's coffee out to them and do all the stuff, and it was really fast paced, and then I was more sensitive to what I was hearing. also as you learn to adapt, then you will change, and you might be hyposensitive more than you used to be because you just kind of learned to cope with it. So I hope this was informative. Next week we'll be talking about tactile hyposensitivity. I wanted to separate them depending on your senses because very few people are strictly hypersensitive and strictly hyposensitive. You'll often have mixtures of each one. It doesn't have to be that you're like strictly one or the other. So that's why I'm dividing it. I'll talk to you guys next week. Bye.